This is Virginia. Virginia is a state in the United States of America. Today, its modern borders look like this, but did you know that it used to be bigger? Well, almost everybody knows that West Virginia was once a part of Virginia, but did you know that Virginia has even been bigger? For that, we need to go back in time when the New World of America was discovered by the Spanish. The Pope drew a line in the map that gave this to Portugal and this to Spain, and as you can see, almost everything now belongs to Spain. There was only one problem: the other European powers were not just going to accept this. It didn't help either that some of these, including England, were soon going to kick out the Pope and become Protestant. This prompted the English to establish a new entity known as the Virginia Company. Consequently, in December of 1606, the newly formed Virginia Company set sail from the British Isles across the Atlantic, with the aim of establishing a permanent settlement in the New World. They landed in the New World 6 months later in May of 1607, and started building a settlement there that they would later call Jamestown. As you can see, this town is located inside the modern state of Virginia, but for now, it is just called the Virginia Colony. This was the Virginia Colony's borders. As you can see, these are just two straight lines that go onto the Pacific Ocean. The Virginia Colony actually controlled about this much land, but this was what they were claiming as theirs. This was pretty normal for the time. You see, Spain claimed all of this as their land, but they only had some small settlements here and there. As more and more English settlements popped up, the colonial population increased. This growth led to the establishment of new colonies, many of which encroached on the territorial claims of the Virginia Colony. While this wasn't seen as a major issue at the time, since all the colonies were still governed and owned by England, it marked the first time Virginia lost land. Moving forward to the Seven Years' War. The Seven Years' War was a conflict between European powers, but that didn't mean that the war stayed only in Europe. No, it spread to all of their colonies too. You see, England, now known as Great Britain's biggest rival at the time, was France. And it just so happens that they were on different sides of the conflict, so the British and French colonialists started fighting, which resulted in the British kicking the French out of mainland America. When the Seven Years' War ended in 1763, it was agreed in the Treaty of Paris that France cede all of their mainland North American claims to Great Britain. This made the now 13 colonies very happy. They wanted to expand into this new land that they had acquired, so it came as a shock when then the King of Great Britain, King George III, signed the Royal Proclamation of 1763. The Royal Proclamation of 1763 forbade all settlements west of the Appalachian Mountains, designating that area as an Indian reservation. The colonialists were outraged by this decision, and it became one of the key factors that contributed to the American Revolution. Following the War of Independence, Virginia joined the new United States of America as a state. When Great Britain and USA discussed peace in 1783, they decided that the new borders between their countries should be here, which meant that Great Britain ceded all of this to the United States of America. A year later, in 1784, Virginia agreed to cede this territory, called the Western Territory, to the official United States government. In exchange, the United States government would take on Virginia's debt. In 1790, Virginia and Maryland agreed to transfer a small piece of land to the government for the establishment of the new nation's capital. Virginia's portion was later returned because the residents felt excluded from the developments taking place on the opposite side of the river. This is also why Washington, D.C. is not a perfect square shape. Later in 1792, Virginia agreed to allow the western part of Virginia to break away and become the 15th state of the United States, which is now known as Kentucky. Fast forward 60 years to the beginning of the American Civil War. During this tumultuous time, Virginia, a slave state, sought to secede from the Union and align itself with the new Confederate States of America. However, a significant obstacle emerged. The northern counties of Virginia opposed this decision. The northern counties of Virginia, characterized by its cooler climate, were not suited for large plantations, which meant that slavery was virtually non-existent in these areas. The American Civil War is too complicated to be explained in this video, but to make it short, Virginia's motivation to secede was primarily to prevent the federal government from abolishing slavery. I have a video on the American Civil War. If you want, you can check it out here, but just so you know, it's quite old and bad. Returning to our main focus, the northern counties of Virginia didn't want to leave the Union. So when Virginia made the controversial decision to break away from the Union in 1861, these counties fought back, and in 1863, they achieved victory, ultimately rejoining the Union as the new state of West Virginia. Following the conclusion of the Civil War and the defeat of the Confederacy, Virginia reached out to West Virginia with an offer to reunite. However, the leaders of West Virginia declined this proposal. So if you look back at history, you can see that Virginia, which is a pretty big state with a large population, could actually be much bigger if things turned out differently. Thanks for watching this video. Remember to like and subscribe. See you next time.